Hi, welcome back. Thanks for joining me. Today we're going to focus on this gray dye and turning it into tuff. For that we need a cobblestone generator, and we'll mix that together in a basin, and out comes tuff. So let's figure out. Oh, hello. That's kind of scary. Anyway, we can get started. So last time, we built this elaborate system to make dye. You know what? We also have not fixed that yet. We need to unclog that machine. Excuse me. One thing to note, though, is this is super clogged up. It does not work properly yet. If I do that, I might be able to unclog it. The problem is that over here, they only come out one at a time. When really what we want is 16 at a time to maximize the processing speed. So it has to come from here, from that. And in order to do that, we have to move this up by one. You know? And I think that's... Actually, why don't we do that? As soon as this is done doing the trees, I think I'm gonna break... machine. There. I have to do this to free it up a little bit. Not enough to pay it for real, but what I can do, ideally, I'd have a couple of brass funnels, but I don't. And so, actually, you know what I may wind up doing? Do I have my super glue here? I do have my super glue here. Say it, but I would like a piece of glowstone while I'm here. I was kind of meaning to do that. Let me pick that up too. Where's my... I thought I picked up some glowstone. It's in my backpack. I am going to break that too. I don't need it for... Here, I should also make that switch. And then I put that there. It's imperfect, but you know what? I don't feel like assembling, dissembling a bunch of times more. This way over here, I think. What happens if I put a button there? Nothing. Nothing happens. In the garbage. Blip. Excuse me. There, I'll do 16 at a time now. And what do I need? I need an apple and a sapling. One stick and one apple. And now we do our crazy glue. You're going to die. that's interesting. I didn't glue that on top, but that looks fine. And I neglected to. Hello? I do like that. It'll be interesting. Improvement. And so we should see, yeah, just getting deleted. Cauldron. I have to make one. A cauldron. And buckets just uses a lot of iron. I shouldn't have bothered. I should have just brought the whole thing over instead of doing this. Did this wrong. These are supposed to be over one, and that's supposed to be over one as well. Thank you. 2. Get power. I got plenty of it. Could put it there. Thank you. is going to work when I have the cobble. Sound just like a villager. I know there was one in there. That's okay. Right behind. Take five of those. machine. And then we need to do iron. Another of the elephants. I actually don't understand how other people are so, well, they're professionals, I guess. See how they're so much more productive. What? Okay, I'm gonna get as many beacons as I can. Clearly. Probably just one that we had. One that they're gonna sell me. I want a beacon. That's the best deal all day. Gotta keep selling these emeralds. They keep dropping off such good stuff. Who's gonna sell me? So. the shears transform to? I'm level 42. I can enchant shears, can't I? Okay. I was making more belts. This one was a thunderstorm.
Really?
I can make it. There. That was a nice pause. Hi, welcome back. While I was off camera, I was fooling around with smelting copper and... Is it zinc? But anyway, I was trying to make molten brass. Was a lot of trial and error and probably not worth watching. Let's see. Molten zinc and molten copper. And what I wound up doing is eventually getting a bunch of brass ingot. So let me walk you through so you understand it, how that it's not super cheaty. It was just an ad hoc little thing I squeezed in over here. So it wasn't really an exciting build. A lot of tinkering. Get some coal first. Oh, and the first thing I did was I added it to the sifter. And so now I drop crushed ore as opposed to... I drop crushed ore instead of nuggets. Which makes a big difference. And so, oh, I don't need to do that. I can show you the existing setup. The first setup was to get buckets of each. And I actually need some coal to show you what's going on. And let me clear that out. So, behind the scenes, it's just a hopper leading to a pile of nuggets because nuggets take forever. We start the fire up. What happens is it slowly smelts, and I would simply just craft a bucket. I'd do this on both sides and craft as much zinc as I had buckets until I got fed up. So it's super manual. I meant to then cook it and put it over there, but it just never. Again, this was just a really messy temporary solution while I was fooling around off camera. For my purposes, I just wanted to bootstrap to get enough to get it to the brass age, and I would do this over and over again. So I would. There. But then I want to. Hello. He's going to kill me. Super chaotic because there's just so many things going on at any one time. Coral block, weather pants, a bizarre map. Onto the roof. I should just build a, 'cause I never need to get onto the roof. So anyway, this is why interesting helmet to try and acquire. Plane. Nope. Two diamonds. I do not have enough to craft. So that I can flex a little. What else do you potentially have here? A Water bending, protection 5, unbreaking 5, respiration, aqua affinity. That's a pretty good. I don't have one of those helmets. Critical thinking, redwood sap. I wanted that. That, sorry, I need a compass. By the way. Excuse me. Compass. Interesting. There's a bazaar somewhere. And since loot was so good out there, probably makes sense. I do want that one, but it's not gonna happen. Another I also started digging. That's where all of this stuff started clearing room for that iron. When I got distracted by the buckets. Let's go back and let me show you again what I'm doing. Taking the molten zinc, molten copper, letting it fill back up. Once I burn through all of this, I'll use the crushed copper ore instead. But building zinc and copper, and I carried it over in drawers. That's sort of what I was doing. Eventually I was going to pipe it, but there just wasn't enough, couldn't figure out enough room in my exhaustion. just keeps filling back up. Don't know why I have three pickaxes. Then what I would do is I have this set up over here. I would drain the buckets into my empty basin, heat it up, and it would then, so let's reverse, put the copper back in. And so I'll take this, and molten brass heads up and out. And I keep, and I would sit there, you know, hand operate the setup. In. And then the zinc. I need another bucket. And I think I need zinc now. Either one. Run out of copper first. That's empty. I dumped the zinc in, and it winds up making what I'm after. And again, it was really mainly just a bootstrap. To get super productive, but I thought, since I was just tinkering around, I thought it would be wasteful to record this and have you watch me tinker. So I think that means I'm out of zinc. The problem is that's too big. So technically I'm just gonna just simplify life a little bit. I do that. Doesn't no clicky. I could do it. I need some space for a pump. Ow. Put that in and fire it back up. Interesting. It doesn't, the crush to it. This is what I'm also learning. Like, I can't fit it, so I will have to pump it in order to make it useful. So in future, I will, instead of just crushing it, what happens if I wash it? Oh, get a chance of gunpowder.
Yes.
Which gives me not the right amount of zinc. Anyway, don't need to watch me struggle with this. I didn't think it was useful. But that's how I got molten everything. Good thing my armor's. Ooh, another gem of the samurai. Okay. But basically, now with those sifters, this becomes really less efficient to come out there. And really, I can just take the output, sift it, and put it in front of a smelter, and get significantly better amounts of everything I'm after. But, so, using that, that's how I got bucket of molten brass, and just use perhaps just melted in it, and boom, brass nuggets, and that's how I wound up with all this brass. What am I going to do with this brass? No, but anyway, oh, I sort of dumped that out, and now I have 7 buckets of molten brass, probably more if I put that down. Oh no, it's less than a bucket. Use the copper because I need a filter. And there we go. I'm going down. That was the walkthrough. He's still here. That's the walkthrough, the brass generation hack I did. Classic vanilla mob. Drops. Actually, I'll put the spider eye if I have one. I'm gonna have the spider eye. Get out of my way, big elephant. So now I will slow down. A little bit more helpful. Got tired of jumping around. Put the building blocks back. Anyway, now that I got the brass, I hit that. Alright, I'm assuming it's not gonna say no to. Next on the quest book is a lot of that. I'm gonna get that. I need to destabilize redstone, which is basically cook polished quartz. Polished quartz takes redstone and nether quartz. Nether quartz comes from diorite. Brimstone, nether quartz. Oh, prismarine crystals also. It's washing soul sand, and I can haunt and wash soul sand. So that's pretty. 12% chance or 50% chance. So times 4, that's 48. If I wash crushed gold at ore, which I happen to have a ton of. This gem is crushed gold, doesn't it? Yeah. Of course I have a fan. Let's get started with the show. Gotta make an armor then. So I just don't have enough diamonds for any of that stuff. 5,000, which is a good sign. This is continuing to work. I see that it is clogged by the cobble gem, which I know is a problem. Okay, I don't know how cobble got way out there. But clearly my cobble gem is going crazy. And I need to move it and have it grind and drill away. I'm gonna hand sort this. Or I'm gonna continue to hand sort. That's generating pretty quickly. But I guess the point is, let me grab my pack of so that's my, that was the walkthrough of my little offline brass creation stuff and a little bit of cleanup. I'll break it here and start up another one to focus on adjusting and fixing the cobble gen for the andesite alloy machine, which I really do want to get to in order to automate, to finally get to the basic mechanism automation, which will take a really good long amount of time. But I'll stop it here. Maybe a little short this time. But thanks a lot. See you next time.